Blondie, who had realised the full commercial potential of punk as the 70s turned to the 80s. The magic ingredient was singer Debbie Harry, one of pop's great female icons.
The first thing I had to do was make the band play properly. You know, I said to them, come on, let's play like a real professional group. Let's play tighter. Let's get the music tight, because it sounds better on the radio that way. And you're terrific musicians, but you don't play together. You're all sort of doing your own thing. Let's start playing together. Then what we have to do is, let's not put out quite so many of these songs that that sort of spit these comical, trashy lyrics out there. Let's use that pop sensibility a bit more and be a bit more emotional in the songs. Let's connect with the people with these lyrics rather than just making them laugh. And they were happy to do that, because nobody had ever really taken the time to say, let's play that again. And we went into the studio first to make that to make Parallel Lines. They didn't know what had hit them, because they'd play it and they'd go, right, next song. What are you talking about, next song? That was horrible. Now we're going to do this track until it's right. Debbie wasn't that concerned about singing perfectly in tune. I was very concerned about it. No, Debbie, you give me the same attitude, but please sing it in tune. Just sing it a couple more times until you get it right. And she understood, okay, I'll do it. Bit reluctant at first.
I think Chapman taught us a lot. The first two albums were done very much the way most people can think an album is done. Just go into the studio and have a good time and play and sort of lay it all down on the tape. And when we finally got to Mike Chapman, it was like school's out, and nobody was ready for it. And he whipped us into shape, and it was very much like doing bodybuilding. And I would play something countless times, and then when I couldn't play it any further, he'd maybe play it another few times, and that would be the one that would go on the record.
Here we were in the process of changing this band that usually just went out there and sort of threw things around and were funny, into a band that was that plus this, real pop music. And this beautiful melody, which was getting a bit lost before, suddenly surfaced. And then I discovered the low Debbie Harry voice as well. She sings beautifully when she sings low. So here she is singing octaves with herself.
If I fear I'm losing you, it's just no good. You're cheesing like never.
Debbie Harry and Blondie helped pop rediscover the virtues of style. The music industry was about to enter a new phase where image would more than ever be the key to a band's success.